Thanks so much for tuning in to another episode of What on Earth to Eat Now. To our subscribers, over 800 of you, we can't believe it. Thank you so much, it means a lot to us. If you do watch these videos and you haven't yet, click that subscribe button, please do. It's entirely free and it really helps us out, helps us to keep making these videos. So let's get back to the recipe. Today is the first episode of four of our Christmas recipes. We're going to be making pears with cinnamon and star anise, slowly cooked in red wine. And it just makes the whole house smell of Christmas, and it's generally rather cheering. Incredibly simple. So let me show you how to do it. So I've got William's pears here, which would be our pear of preference for this recipe, but Comice is fine, and to be honest, any pear you can find will be just fine, as long as it's ripe. You don't want to try this with an unripe pear. This recipe is for six people, so we're going to do a pear each. So I'm just going to take six pears. So I'm just going to peel these pears. I like to leave the stalks on. So I've peeled my pears, and I'm just going to slice them in half, choosing one side of the stem to go down so that I don't cut it off by accident, like so. I'm going to take a melon baller I've got here, but you can easily use a teaspoon. And I'm just going to remove the core and take if there's anything at the bottom to take off, but I will leave the stem like that. So that's my finished half. And I am being quite gentle and quite careful, because you'll see any kind of big gashes or skin that you've left on once you've cooked it, and it kind of ruins the effect. So just take your time to do this. So I've got my pears ready. Don't worry about lemon juice. Any discoloration will be hidden by the red wine we're going to poach them in. And I've got 200 grams of caster sugar here, 8 star anise, and a stick of cinnamon. And I'm just going to go over and cook them now. So I'm going to heat my sugar in my pan. And again, you want a pan that's going to be large enough that you can put each of your pears core side down and they have contact with the base of the pan, so we can get some nice color on them. So I'm going to heat that gently. So I've heated my sugar for a couple of minutes, and I'm just going to slowly put each pear core side down. Making sure I can fit them all flat on the pan. There we are. So the sugar's nearly all melted, and I'm just going to put in my aromatics. So I've got my cinnamon there and my star anises. They smell so exotic. And a pinch of black pepper. You won't really taste it, but it'll bring a bit of warmth to the pears. I've got 250ml of red wine here, and I've got my cartouche, which is just a fancy name for a circle of greaseproof paper that fits inside the frying pan. So my sugar's all melted, and I'm just going to put my 250ml red wine in. And then I'm going to put my cartouche on top. It smells absolutely delicious. Pop that on top like so. And I'm going to reduce the heat to the medium heat, and I'm going to let them simmer for about 25 minutes. So it's been about 20 minutes. And I'm gonna just take my cartouche off and I'm going to let the rest of the red wine just evaporate until there's a very tiny amount in the bottom. The pears should be quite soft, but still holding their shape. I'm going to turn the heat up a bit as well. So I'm just going to let this evaporate until the pears are slightly stuck to the bottom, but not completely stuck. If you're not sure or you're a bit worried about burning them, you can just gently turn one over and have a look. But what we're looking for is just a nice bit of caramelization on the pears. So that's not quite got enough color on it, so I'm just going to flip it back over. So pretty much all of the wine has evaporated and I've got that lovely golden colour. I'm just going to add 150ml of water and I'm going to turn it off completely. And that's just to stop the sugar from hardening, so I've got a bit of syrup. So my pears are beautifully cooked. I forgot to mention, this is from our first cookery book, The Kitchen Orchard, which you can buy. I'm gonna serve them simply with a bit of our vanilla custard, which is a ridiculously easy recipe. We're going to be showing it to you in the forthcoming video, so stay tuned. I'm just going to serve it up like so. A really simple, festive pudding. And it's also gluten-free, naturally, so beautiful festive pears. That lovely syrup. Et voila, your festive pears with cinnamon and star anise. Thanks so much for tuning in to another episode of What on Earth to Eat Now. I do hope you enjoyed. If you did, don't forget to like and subscribe. We'll see you again next week for another one of our Christmas specials.